Hey guys, it's Katie. Welcome back to my channel today for Fun Friday, and we are doing a literal trash to treasure. I've got these two pickle jars. I've been having a hard time with throwing away stuff like this, glass like this, so I wanted to make them over. The one pickle jar still has the label on it. I decided not to take it off, partially because I did not have any more goo gone, and partially because I knew I could just cover it up with what I was doing. The only other thing that we're going to need is some twine and decoration and my glue gun. So I have seen, and I have a fun little hobnail. Is that what you call it? Is that the word, hobnail looking, jar? And I have just been looking at it and thinking, oh my gosh, I wonder if I could do that with glue, with hot glue. So we're testing it out today. And actually, when you see the end result, it's not 100% like what I was thinking, but it works out just fine. So I went along, I just laid down some tape so that I could kind of keep a straight line. And then I just put the little dots of hot glue along that line. And then I moved the tape down and then just kind of did it in a, like in between. So they kind of rotate in and out. And I went all along the jar and did that. So I was really excited actually with how things were looking. There is quite a bit of the stringy glue. So if anybody has any tips or tricks on how to maybe not get that stringy glue, maybe it's the glue gun, maybe it's the glue. I don't know. Maybe it's the temperature. I don't know. I got a fairly decent glue gun, I think. I don't know. But anyway, I went all along the jar and added the dots. So now for this other one, I had saw someone had a super cute little like honeycomb look. Well, I could not recreate that. The dots were hard enough. So in the night, I was thinking about it, and I remembered that I had this chicken wire that I picked up from Hobby Lobby or Michaels, and it's been a long time. It's been in my stash since at least last year. And so I thought, well, maybe I could get the same desired effect. And so again, let's just try it out. Let's see how it goes. So the wire is pretty hard to work with. You need to be very careful. I probably should have actually had gloves on, but I made it work. And then it was a matter of trying to get it to stick to the jar. So I thought that this spray adhesive that I had would work. It didn't work. It's all gummed up. What else is new? So I thought maybe Mod Podge would hold it. No, Mod Podge didn't hold it either, even with the blue painter's tape. So I had to just pull out the hot glue gun and hot glue it down. I'm probably not going to resell this or anything. I don't know what I'm going to do with it. I just thought it was kind of a fun idea. And actually, it turns out being the one that I like the most. So I used the hot glue and I just glued the backs down, and I just made sure that that was going to be the back of my jar, whatever. And then we went outside, and you guys, look at that sunshine. Oh my gosh. In Montana, it was almost 60 degrees today. So I used this white spray paint, and I just spray painted it, the whole thing, really, really good. Made sure I got a good, nice, even coat. It was so windy and the brown paper was blowing around and whatever, but that sunshine felt so nice to be outside doing projects like this. Now, at this point, I'm like, oh my, look at how nice that hobnail looks. Except I can now see all those little glue strings. So again, if you have some tips and tricks, let me know. But I'll show you guys how I remedied that. So I painted it all up, got it all spray painted really good, and then left it outside to dry, and I enjoyed the rest of that sunshiny afternoon. And then when things cooled off, I came back in the house. I am loving that it's finally spring. Oh my goodness. So let's try to fix this up. I'm actually really excited with how they are looking at this point. It didn't exactly get the desired effect on this one with the chicken wire. Like, I kind of thought the chicken wire would stick a little bit closer to the jar, but it didn't. So in this video, it's hard to see, but you can, in real life, you can still see all those little strings, and I kind of feel like it made it worse. So I pulled out my embossing gun or my heat gun, and I just kind of melted some of them and then pulled off some of the bigger ones. And then I did do a little bit, more of a light sanding on it, and that really made it look a little bit better. After I pulled some of that off and sanded it, I did go back out and just add another quick layer of spray paint to it, and it turned out perfect. So for the top of it, I just wanted to use some fun twine, and I just made sure that the part that was going to be the front was the least icky part as far as how everything looked. And then I just added a little bit of greenery, and actually that was so stinking cute. Now for this jar, I used some wider twine, and actually this twine is like for paper card craft making. And you could still see some like the date on there, and I really wanted to kind of cover it up. I put a couple layers of spray paint and that didn't work, so I just used some more of that greenery and painted or covered it up. Stay tuned, guys, because I've got another trash to treasure project, and then I will reveal all of it at the end of the video. I just wanted to take a minute to let you guys know that it's National Craft Month, and with that I am relaunching my YouTube channel, and I'm also doing some weekly lives, so make sure you check out the links down below. Here on YouTube, Mondays are Maker Mondays, and then Fridays are Fun Fridays, and you can find the links to all my social media down below. So more trash to treasure projects. These little springs came out of a seat cushion. I went up on the hill and I pulled the whole seat out of an old car, and I plucked all of those little pieces apart. I've got so many of them and I love it. But I wanted to make some cute little Easter, or even not necessarily Easter, I guess more springy type things. So I've got some Spanish moss. I've got these cute little eggs that I got last year as well. And I've got some lamb's ear. And then I literally pulled that green stem stuff back out of the garbage from some other floral stuff that I had been using. My daughter had been chasing me around with it and whacking me with it, and I had put it in the garbage. And so I decided to pull it back out and use it. And I'll show you what I'm going to do. So I just kind of made little nests with the Spanish moss. And then I took the little green pieces. And like I said, I had taken all the greenery off of that. And I'm just going to use this Waverly truffle brown paint. It's a chalk paint from Walmart, and paint these up so that they look a little bit more like sticks. Hey, how about that? What a good idea. We don't even have trees where we live, so I wouldn't have been able to go out and find some real branches. So now I'm just going to cut apart some of the lamb's ear and hot glue that into a couple of places. Hot glue in the eggs in a couple of places. And oh my gosh, these just kind of are a fun little something different, and just utilizing trash, really. I mean, the bed springs or the car seat strings, and then the trash wood stems that I pulled out of the garbage can. So those are my two projects for today. If you guys love this, let me know. I love it, and I'm super excited. Here it seems to look like that didn't turn out too darn bad, and actually I'm pretty dang excited with it. It turned out way better than I thought it was going to when I started spray painting it. So again, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Make sure you comment, give me some love, and I hope to do a few more of these in the future. All right, everybody, have a great day. I'll see you Monday for Maker Monday.